sky. I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin. My hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Margaret died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for your departed servant, Margaret, also find new strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. And at this time, I invite our first reader to come forward.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. Who can find a woman of worth? Far beyond jewels is her value. Her husband trusts her judgment. He does not lack income. She brings him profit, not loss, all the days of her life. She seeks out wool and flax and weaves with skillful hands. Like a merchant fleet, she secures her provisions from afar. She rises while it is still night and distributes food to her household, a portion to her maidservants. She picks out a field and acquires it. From her earnings, she plants a vineyard. She girds herself with strength. She exerts her arms with vigor. She enjoys a profit from her dealings. Her lamp is never extinguished at night. She puts her hands to the distaff, and her fingers ply the spindle. She reaches out her hands to the poor, and extends her arms to the needy. She's not concerned for her household when it snows. All her charges are doubly clothed. She makes her own coverlets. Fine linen and purple are her clothing. Her husband is prominent at the city gates, as he sits with the elders of the land. She makes garments and sells them, and stocks the merchants with belts. She is clothed with strength and dignity and lasts at the days to come. She opens her mouth in wisdom. Kindly instruction is on her tongue. She watches over the affairs of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her blessed. Her husband, too, praises her. Many are the women of proven worth, but you have excelled them all. Charm is deceptive and beauty fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Acclaim her for the work of her hands, and let her deeds praise her at the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Like a child lost in its mother's arms, so will I rest in you. Like a child lost in its mother's arms, so will I rest in you. My God, I am not proud. I do not look for things too great. My God, I trust in you. You care for me. You give me peace. O Israel, trust in God. Now and always trust in God. Like a child rest in its mother's arms, so will I rest in you. Like a child rest in its mother's arms, so will I rest in you.
And at this time, I invite our second reader to come forward.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory
to you, O Lord. When he saw the crowds, Jesus went up the mountain. And after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. First of all, on behalf of our entire parish family here, I would like to extend our many condolences and promises of prayer for you and for Margaret, for your whole family here today. I'd also like to extend a welcome to anyone who may be watching on YouTube today to be here and be present in a virtual way for Margaret's funeral mass. So we thank you for being here. These are the Beatitudes. This is the great Sermon on the Mount that Jesus gives to us. It's the greatest sermon of all time. Oddly enough, this one gospel reading is the only gospel reading that appears both in the rite of funerals as well as for the rite of marriage. It's the only one that the church selected as an appropriate gospel reading for both the most happy occasion of our entire lives as well as maybe one that is the saddest. I think that there's something about that there's a truth in the blessings of God, that they are with us at every moment in life. You know, I was reading a little bit about Margaret to get to know her. And whenever I think in terms of Beatitudes, I try to look at a person's life in terms of, you know, what are those special blessings that God has given to them in their life. You know, the Beatitudes, after all, are a list of examples that Jesus has given to us. They're a list of examples of the blessings. Certainly today, we can relate with, "Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted." It's one of Jesus' many blessings and promises to us. But as we look in Margaret's life, I think we can find other Beatitudes at play. And we do this in the spirit of these being examples that Jesus gives us. I would say, blessed are those who have strong relationships in their lives. That's something that Margaret had. She had a very strong relationship, certainly with God and with Mother Mary. I think these were sort of the backbone of her faith, her family, her friends. These were the most important parts of her entire life. Her faith. Blessed are those who have a strong faith. Now, we know that Margaret was a woman of prayer. She loved her rosary. She loved
spending time praying to Mary. The Hail Mary was her favorite prayer. This scripture reading that we heard, our first reading today, Proverbs 31, may have been her favorite scripture reading. It was marked out in her Bible. And perhaps it was her favorite reading because it really, in a very practical way, was sort of God's way of showing us how we can live. And certainly in her own life, she endeavored to live by Proverbs 31. She loved music. I think music also ties into her love of prayer. You know, after all, when we sing, we're praying twice. But music really was something that was important to her. She was a musician. She played the organ. She probably played the organ for other people's funerals at some point in her life. She would drive a long way just to get to the church. I think it was in, I was reading this earlier today, St. Joseph in Rockdale. And she would drive, I think she got paid like a dollar. It was like nothing. She got paid like a dollar to do this, and she probably spent more on gasoline just to get there and back. But it was something that was so important to her. It wasn't about the money. It was about those relationships. Everything ties back to that. Blessed are those who have a love of music. She had a sentimental heart. And I think you guys found that out pretty recently in as you were going through and maybe trying to look for some pictures, you found some hidden treasure. Thank you cards, birthday cards, Christmas cards, just lots of artwork and maybe things that were drawn or painted or things that were given to her over the years that she just never would throw out. She'd just keep it. Because every single one of those was an important memory, a special memory to her. She loved to cook. Blessed are those who love to cook. And blessed are those who have somebody in their lives who loves to cook. Some of the things that she would do, she would even tailor her cooking to the needs of those who she was cooking for. So if there was like a special dietary need, or she would just make sure that she would go out of her way to make sure that it was special, even with any of the restrictions or needs that might have come up in the recipes. And it was delicious. It was absolutely delicious. Some of the best moments probably were around that kitchen table, sharing together. And so we are a people of Beatitudes. We live out the Beatitudes that Jesus gives us, but then we build upon them with very unique and special blessings that God gives to us, the very unique and special blessings that God gave to Margaret. And then today, I think the words from our second reading probably say it best. You know, when it's all said and done, and God calls us home to be with Him, wouldn't it be nice, like St. Paul to Timothy, who says, "Beloved, I am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith." I think Margaret finished that race and she kept the faith. She gave you the example to build on. She gave you the Beatitudes to build on. Keep building on the Beatitudes.
Let us now stand together as we bring our prayers and petitions before God the Almighty Father.
That the bishops and priests of the church and all who preach the gospel may be given the strength to express to action the word they proclaim. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those in public office may promote justice and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may call Margaret to happiness in the company of all the saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who bear the cross of pain in body or mind may never feel forsaken by God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For openness in reaching out to all the people of the world, that together we may walk out of darkness and into God's light. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in the peace of Christ, and those whose faith is known to God alone, that they may have a place in God's eternal kingdom, and for those who mourn, that they may be confident of God's abiding love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our Father, we thank you for hearing our prayers this day as we lift them up to you. We ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord. Amen. You may be seated. Let us stand. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Margaret may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Holy,
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 holy Lord.
Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let us kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Ronald, our Bishop, Daniel, our retired Bishop. Remember your servant, Margaret, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Let us now stand together, and at the Savior's command,
and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Let us kneel. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. And just a heads up about communion today. So the way that we're doing communion during the pandemic is I'm actually going to bring communion to you today. So you'll remain in your pews today. There's a couple of ministers that are going around right now, actually with hand sanitizer. So if you intend to receive communion today, please get a little spritz of the hand sanitizer. What I would ask you, if you would like to receive communion today, I would ask you to please stand. If you would rather not receive communion today, that's okay. Just please remain seated in your pew. But standing helps me to know who would like to receive today. One other instruction too, we only receive communion on the hand. Body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The blessings of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Adonis Angelicus.
Body of Christ. Blessings of Christ, body of Christ, body of Christ, Christ, the blessings of Christ, the body of Christ, the body of Christ, the body of Christ.
Christ. Angelicus,
body of Christ. Blessings of Christ.
Oh, per
Pope, Christ.
Salvus a tu milis. Oh, per
Christ.
Pope, salvus, salvus a tu
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Margaret, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister Margaret. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Choirs of angels lead you into paradise, and may the martyrs come to welcome you, to bring you home into the holy city, so you may dwell with Jerusalem. Be holy angels, be there at your welcome. With all the sea to go before you there, that you may enter into everlasting rest. May holy angels be there at your welcome, with all the sea to go before you there, that you
hands forward in a gesture of blessing with me. Margaret, into the hands of our Father of mercies, we commend you in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, you will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Margaret in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us. Listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith. Until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.
Was good.